Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the fourth session of the Brewkali Kona video series on our YouTube channel. Last time, in the third session, we focused on an overview on the products itself. But this time, we want to focus on one product line of our product portfolio, and this is really the Cobot Solutions. Today, we also changed the location, and we are here now in the production area, in a section where the last tests with the Cobot solution are happening. Here we are doing the last measurements on the applications of the customers before the delivery of the products. And I have a new guest now in this fourth session. It's Daniel. Yep. He's a long-term member of the customized solutions team, and he's a project leader there. He's in contact with our customers on a daily basis. He is an expert on the applications itself, but also on the technical features that are built in this kind of a product solution. Daniel, please explain us, support me in what are the advantages in terms of a solution compared to our other products.
Thank you, Herbert, for your introduction. I would say with the Cobot solutions, we have three USPs. Number one, we have the 3D high resolution focus variation technology with the R25 sensor. Number two, other than with our other tabletop systems, we don't just have three, four, or five axes, we have a seven axis system. And number three, the measurement volume, we can measure heavy and large parts because we have a measurement reach of 1.3 meters radius from this base.
Yeah, and the base seems to be very robust, big for heavy, bigger parts. So can you explain us in detail what is built here in this base?
So this base consists of two parts.
Why is it a two-part space?
It's two parts because in the lower part you can integrate an air damping system to minimize the effects of vibration onto the measurements. And further details here, we have a drawer where we open that up. We have a 21-inch touch screen monitor. We have an operator panel here with the main switch, with an operator mode switch, so you can change from a manual mode to automatic mode, and we have a reset button here.
Okay, so the monitor and the operator table is really integrated already in the solution. So I think it would be time now that you show us really from the operator table how does it work and how do you operate the Cobot solution.
Sure. At first, I can rotate the monitor into my direction. Second, I take the sensor by its handlebars, and by clicking the right joystick, I can activate the teach mode and move the Cobot to the first measurement position. By clicking on the left joystick, I can activate the laser pointer. And now, by clicking the joysticks, I can adjust the position. In the Automation Manager software, I can add this measurement position. Now I would like to add a second position. So I move the Cobot sensor to the second position, make a fine adjustment, and add this second position. After teaching in the two measurement positions, we have to define the calculation method. In here, we select a simple roughness measurement. You make your definitions. This is okay like this. And you save your measurement program. Now you're ready to start your teached-in program. The measurement is finished, and here you can see the result page.
So, Daniel, this is a product that is a perfect solution for the production near metrology.
Yeah.
It really handles bigger parts, heavier parts. You can measure features on different points of interest. But nevertheless, for me, it's still our sensor on a cobalt solution. So where is the know-how that your team and you were putting in during the development phase of this product?
So our customer solution team brought in a lot of ideas which we realized with these cobalt solutions. So Urban, let's try it. I will describe you some features and you can count them. As a key feature, we have the R25 sensor mounted on the universal robot. We have the handlebars, we have a joystick, we have very flexible cabling. The base of the universal robot, you can move it onto different locations on the cobot. We have connection possibility for USB or also for Ethernet to allow the connection to the customer IT landscape. You can also move the cobot by the use of a pallet truck to different locations, so you're very mobile on the shop floor. And the software is allows the overall process control, so you have the measurement teach-in, the measurement itself, and also the calculation until to the reporting. So you have the overall process. And a very important key feature here on this cobot is the hardware. We have the fully integrated hardware of an Alicona control server, of a robot control server, and of an additional PLC unit. And don't forget all the safety features we have on that cobot.
So I calculated now approximately 10 points, and you convinced me, you did a perfect job in the development of this product, and it really makes it, as it seems, an integrated solution for shop floor metrology. But let me come back to your last point, the safety. Is it really that important, and is it very often requested from the customer?
Safety is a very important topic for our customers. In fact, the cobots are built according to international standards. You can have a cobot which is built according to the European Measuring Directive, but you can also have a cobot which is built according to standards of different countries. For example, in the US, you have the UL standards. But of course, we have other safety features here. Erwin, please come here. I would like to demonstrate one of these. Just stand here. Mm-hmm. And please start the already teach-in measurement program.
I think I know what's coming now. I think you'd like to show this on exhibition as well, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, that's a great feature, a great security feature, safety feature. But do you have also others built in?
Yeah, we have other features, of course, built in to this cobot. So we have four emergency stops on all four corners of the cobot. We have signal lights indicating the current system status. And as you know, we have different cobots also with additional rotation axis or different axis. So you can have a laser scanner, which is scanning and monitoring the area around the cobot. And if someone steps into this area, the cobot can stop or it can move with a reduced speed.
I know from one customer who has this kind of functionality, a customer from Brazil, measuring saw blades, so the cutting edges of saw blades, so he needs the horizontal axis to be able to rotate the saw blade, and then he's measuring all kind of parameters on the cutting edge, like edge break, radius, or wear of the cutting edge. Then the system itself is also used a lot in the aerospace industry, so we are measuring turbine components, all kind of turbine components, the edge break, and also other features of bigger parts. And then a very interesting application from the UK, a customer is integrating this kind of solution in his manufacturing process, so it's a really a closed loop process, and the customer is monitoring the tool wear in the turning machine. A very interesting, fully integrated solution.
And Urban, don't forget about roughness measurements. With the R25 sensor, you can also make high resolution images and use it for roughness measurements. And you can also stitch a lot of images, so you can have a bigger area to measure.
Yeah, thank you for reminding me about this. So it's really a solution for form and roughness. So really two applications with one solution. Daniel, thank you very much. I enjoyed this vlog.
You're welcome.
Very much. This time, ladies and gentlemen, if you are interested in this kind of a product line, please follow our YouTube channel. Please comment, send questions or whatever. We see you next time to the next vlog. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Bye.